Ciao. By your sweet, super soft, romantic Principessa Silkita.
Yeah. Some people search for a fountain. The promise is forever young. Some people need the dozen roses. And that's the only way you prove your love.
So Mimi, he was 21 and he picked me up when I was 13 and officially when I was 14 now declared. The entire Estella group made fun of him, called him Roman, like Roman Polanski, after the story that he had gone out with Natasha Kinski, Klaus Kinski's daughter, when Natasha was 13. Yeah, he had now a reputation. That made me a whore though, because we were together for 2 years after I had met him in the group. When I was 13, he was there always, once a week, the meetings. He would organize things. And 14 and 15, I was with him. And now 16, I split. And 18, I met Pacuco. And I was with him for 2.5 years in Germany. Then we went to Mexico. And then I was much longer with him. But my cousin Yenya, in all these years, I never met her one single boyfriend. Or my cousin Andre, not one girlfriend. Ever. Exploitative and abusive. Needless to say, they lived in Latin America, they did never learn how to dance. Although Andre deemed so once, I went visit. He was visiting too. He picked me up from Helga's house, home, to take me dancing. Yeah, that was merengue. That was like polka, rumba, umpa, umpa, umpa. No, he was so fascinated with that, but he never learned how to proper dance at all. Oh, and my cousin, Andre, by the way, when I was in high school, he went to squat. To empty buildings, which now were filled with graffiti. It's disgusting. No, I never set foot on that. And of course he liked house music, like every German asshole. That's not music, it's just bah, bah, bah. It's disgusting. When he brought me to the dance place, we walked behind the train station. No, I had been there as a teenager, but well. And there were so many little flyers on the poles asking for missing people, like missing women. And that was the time suddenly drugs came in really strong. But that was the thing my cousin Andre had in a way fomented with the squatting and the group he was hanging out. That never made a connection, right? What that means, what they were doing. It was scary. So, when I moved to San Francisco, they came to visit me. And then they exited. And I thought, oh, cool, now I can have contact with my cousin. So I Skyped her. And she would not accept my calls. I had to look into it. What is going on? I mean, not once, continuously. She would not accept my Skype calls. Or not return them either. I looked into it and I kind of felt what it was. She was jealous of me. Because now I had somebody and somebody also liked my kids. One day she took a call, but she immediately knocked it off and said, yeah, she had no time to talk. Which was absolutely against the way she had depicted herself when she came visit me in Cuernavaca. Oh, I'm so cool, I'm so cool. That's her little flag in the wind. I'm such a cool person. Not sure why though. Well, then there was this man who had a furniture store in Berkeley. That was her lover. He was definitely married. And ugly too. But sensitive. She abused him big time.
Oh, to see without my eyes the first time that you kissed me.